Yeah, well, it kind of was by accident. It wasn't like me thinking, oh, I want to start a clothing brand, I want to start a business. I was just looking around at the time, basically for clothes to buy. And with that, I just couldn't kind of find the right style I wanted. I just wanted something simple and clean kind of thing. So I just thought the idea of making my own. Then I'd got like the drafts of them made up, shown them to Dan, who I run Gacha with.
Originally, Dan McGovern came to me with the idea of getting a few tees made up as samples. We were both really keen on the designs that we'd found, so we both put our money together, which was £800, and we got the samples made. Then once the samples arrived, we both fell in love with the fit and designs and thought we have a real good little business idea.
I think after we ordered our original samples, we got together a day and kind of just wrote a list of everything you need to start like a little independent business. For us at the time, it was just basic stuff like labels, packaging, postage bags, even stuff just like profit margins, how many units we wanted to get, like the price of that. Also coming up with a name and stuff like that. So we done like a big list of names, didn't we? Yeah, like brainstormed like 50 names. Number one on that list was Gacha, not meant to be. So we got over some
bad names.
Yeah, so got over some bad names. So we had like Icon Tees, Cherry Bomb. You know, I think we had something to do with turtles at one point. But yeah, Gacha stuck, and Gacha actually means one piece treasure in Japanese. So we did, that's not, we originally got the idea when we heard the surname Gacha, and it kind of jumped out the way I heard it be said, and then looked into it, like, and when we kind of were thinking, oh, we like the sound of this, when we seen it had another meaning in Japanese, and we're very inspired by Japanese style and culture. I kind of put the nail in the coffin and
put some fonts together and then found the blood.
Been Gacha since, found the blood. We wanted these kind of tops, just basic, you know, simple, nice fit with a print on. I just couldn't find them anywhere online. So the kind of initial idea was just getting clothes made for ourselves, and then seemed other people liked it, and just kind of kicked on from there.
So at first I was skeptical because personally, I didn't actually know anyone that had created their own business. So this was really new to both of us. So initially I would say that my only worry was, would we succeed or would we be slated on social media because we were putting ourselves out there?
The last job I was at, I left about 4 months after we started Gacha. So it was, we had like next to no money in the bank. We definitely didn't have any money to pay ourselves a wage. So it wasn't certain, because this was kind of the best job I'd kind of fell into. I'd worked a couple of years to get into this kind of role. But then I just kind of wanted to be doing something I wanted to do. I wasn't passionate about this job. And then, it was a mixture of excitement and uncertainty, but the excitement was just doing it for myself, you know, like the time I put into it and the energy I put into it is what I'll get out of it kind of thing.
At first, we were sourcing the t-shirts from a company in Manchester, who also provided the t-shirts printed on. We then took them to my nan's, and she personally removed all the original labels on the t-shirts and re-sewn the new Gacha labels into them.
And then from there, my dad had helped us bag them all up, and yeah, it was really just like a very organic growth, if you know what I mean. But it was very do-it-yourself to start with.
To begin with, we just decided to go with, say, key figures and some personal favourites of our own, from whether it be movies or rappers or whatnot. So we started with Tony Montana Scarface tee. We had a Biggie Smalls tee, and we had a Pablo Escobar tee.
One of my personal favourite tops we've done is the tit tee, and that is the combination of the word for a woman's chest and a t-shirt, and that was one of the original tops we've done, and I think that just really helped the brand stand out from the other brands. Quite eye-catching. Got like a female custom on board a bit more, and we had this 90-year-old nan sewing labels into her t-shirts
with
a pair of boots on. So,
So I'd say the business has changed dramatically, whether it be financially or with our product alone. Now it's actually produced in Turkey, and it could be delivered in the tens of thousands, all packaged up, ready to be sent out by ourselves. So we've really improved the quality of each of our items. summer of 2018, I went to Ibiza, myself and three of my friends, and we were outside, and all of a sudden, this rapper from London called Nines, Courtney Freckleton, his real name is, was outside actually having a smoke with his friends, so we ended up getting speaking to him, told him about the brand at this stage. It was very early, so we only had a few thousand followers, if that, and he was really, really buying into it, but unfortunately he got a bit carried away with a few girls that he was with, so we actually didn't end up getting any further than that for that day. But we were just happy to have spoke to him. Funny enough, he stayed another two nights. He walks in again with a few of his friends, and we couldn't believe our luck. We had the t-shirts on us just in case we bumped into someone or something we could get a photo opportunity with. So we ended up approaching him. He remembered us from a few nights before. We just asked him if he could put on the t-shirt for us, we can get a photo with him. And he just ended up holding the t-shirt, which was good enough for us. But he didn't have a t-shirt. So he just held the t-shirt and we got the photo, and I sent it straight home to Dan McGovern.
We had Anthony Joshua's
manager, David Ganza.
Yeah.
He was actually wearing the t-shirt the other week on
Sky Sports Box Office.
Office for the Yusuf Chisora boxing match. So that was a more recent one that we were really happy with.
That was a good one,
We both actually had COVID at the start of January, unfortunately. So that we were actually out of work for about a week while we were isolating.
That's done in for about a month,
But I mean, everyone's been in the same boat with it, really. So with us, we had all the shops shutting, so we weren't
We didn't have any stock for six, because our stock kind of ran out in, say, I think it was about April, but obviously the lockdown coming in March, didn't it? So we obviously didn't have any stock for 6 months, but we just had a good start to the year before then. And then the last, like, 4 or 5 months of the year were unbelievable for us when everything kind of opened up again. So overall, we had a good year, but it was a very big time of uncertainty. It's been good and bad, but I think we've come out of it better than other people, so we certainly can't complain with it, Yeah, we're at a really positive moment for us currently. I think from 2019 to 2020, the turnover times by around 8 times. So it's a really positive moment for us. I'd say one specific area where it's grown incredibly is the wholesale side of things. So I think now we're in 25 stores across the UK and France. We're speaking to stores in Italy. We're hoping to expand with more stores in the UK. I think we are really just getting started with everything. You know, this is our time to grow, man. Yeah, this is our year. I'd say more than anything, just back yourself.
Put yourself out there, come out of your comfort zone and believe in the plan that you have. You never know if something is going to work until you give it a try.
And just make sure you like what you do, man, you know. Like, I think that's an important part of it. I've done jobs for years where just haven't been into it, felt no passion, you know. This is just a different ball game, so.
Everyone faces setbacks, you just need to find a way around them.
If you don't believe in your nobody, you know what I mean?